4. Sorry. I don't know. So you see, when the telephone... Oh, put it... Yeah, I think it's always wise to silence your phone before you enter the... Thank you. I always do this. Anyway, I hope you will enjoy this concert that is a concert for harpsichord, an instrument that was very popular in the Baroque era. But Faythe and her friends are going to perform pieces that were actually written in the 20th century. So it's a moment of rebirth of the use of the harpsichord in music. I hope you can also come back next Thursday for the for Wendy Richman, viola, who is artist in residence here. Please notice the exit in case you really hate the concert and want to escape, or there is a fire or minor problems like that. So I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you next Thursday.
Thank you for coming to today's concert that takes a look at some really interesting and unique repertoire for the harpsichord. It's thought of primarily as a Baroque instrument, the harpsichord, and it wasn't used during the classical or romantic eras. But beginning at the 20th century, it started to be rediscovered and there was a revival in it. One of the early pioneers of this movement was Wanda Landowska. She was a harpsichordist that traveled all over Europe and the United States performing on the instrument. And she performed Baroque music, but she also encouraged her contemporaries to start writing new music for the harpsichord. And that's when we start seeing it become considered a modern instrument. The first piece we played was written for her by Defia, so you can see that kind of continuation. The next piece on the program jumps ahead 60 years to Libby Larson. And in this piece, we can see how composers' view of the harpsichord has really evolved. She uses all the unique colors of the instrument to really portray the picture she's going for of a boat floating down a lake or a river in a sailboat. This piece also uses the lute stop on the harpsichord, which sounds like this. It's dampening the strings, so this is what it typically sounds like. And then if it's dampened, you can hear it sounds a bit like a guitar. I have to make sure I turn it off or I'll be really surprised if I start playing. So that piece uses that. And then the last piece on the program jumps back to 1950. And this piece by Elliott Carter is a really, really important piece that is played by harpsichordists a lot. It is a great chamber music work that really considers the harpsichord as an equal instrument to all the other ones playing as well. And Elliott Carter's personal composition style lends itself to the instrument very well also. Even today, there is not a lot of chamber music that is written for the harpsichord in contemporary style. And so even though the Elliott Carter piece is actually considered old by now, contemporary music's really counted the last 30 years, even though it's older than that, it still is played by harpsichordists and is a mainstay in our repertoire because it's so good. And it's just such a great piece that we still play it all the time. And then if you can convince people to play it with you that also want to play it, it's even better. So you'll enjoy the rest of this performance, and thank you again for coming today.
Thank you. Thank you.